Anxiety is an ugly thing. I felt like I couldn't move, no matter how much I tried. I had the impression that someone was about to get me. I also felt like I was in a deep hole that I could not climb out of. After escaping that witch, I felt completely unsafe. And when I was back at home, the days did not look as pretty as they used to. The ocean felt far away. And even food didn't taste as good as it used to. I realized that it's not that easy to distinguish good from bad. And people like that witch, or the exotic owner of the iron factory, were not as good as they seemed. Yeah, I had a few rough days. But the one thing that helped me was having Jose here with me. He did all he could to get me out of that hole. Quite literally, actually, as he made me get out of that bunker that I built. And after rescuing those poor turtles from those cages, I felt good. I felt I could make a difference by helping others. Day after day, that fear felt further and further away from me. Now, we've been having some great times together here at home. After a day relaxing in the ocean, it was time to get back to work. The success of Jose's business at Dusk Harbor meant one thing. People actually liked my food. So we decided to open a restaurant with the money we made. I was working on a new dish for a menu, but I was stuck. I tried every ingredient I knew, but I could not find the right one. So a quick trip to the local market for some fresh ingredients would be the perfect way to end the day. However, as I made my way to the city, I started to feel a little uneasy. Yeah. That night, Cactus City was attacked by the Drowned. Drowned are ocean creatures. From time to time, they attack villages at the coast. But there hasn't been a Drowned attack like that in ages. Everyone thought that the Drowned moved away from this ocean, but tonight's attack showed everybody that they were still around. A few days after the attack, the market was still very quiet. There was a new sign on the board. The Drowned leader was identified as Riptide, an old Drowned who used to terrorize the area, and a handsome reward was offered for his head. Jose, of course, knew everything about them. According to him, thousands of days ago, long before the Age of Villagers, the Drowned dominated the oceans. They were the most advanced civilization in the region and lived in huge underwater cities, known as Drowned Cities. However, something happened to the world, and they were almost wiped out of existence. Their numbers decreased drastically, and the few that survived now live in the ocean ruins of their old cities. Today, they're not really a threat, unless one of them holds a mighty weapon. A trident. All I wanted to do was to finish the dish that I was working on, but if those attacks continued, I would be in trouble. Not only the market in Cactus City is the place that I go to get my ingredients, but my house is right next to it. This means I can also be attacked at any time. I had to face my fears, so I decided to go looking for the leader of the Drowned. I started to think that it could not be possible to search an entire ocean for those creatures, even with my frog abilities. After many days searching, I was ready to call off my search. I mean, I'm a simple frog who likes to cook. Maybe I should go back to my ingredient hunt. I still needed to come up with a dish for a menu anyway. Besides, I'm not a bounty hunter, and everybody was searching for them. So it was only a matter of time until someone capture or kill Riptide. As I made my way to the fish market, that was now almost back to normal, I encountered a group of sailors in the hunt for Riptide. They were in need of a good swimmer for their expedition. Being the only frog around these parts, I introduced myself and accepted the job. This was a fun crew. They were all simple villagers that, on occasion, would do some extra work for some money. Not before long, I was deep in a conversation with a fisherman, exchanging recipes and tips about our favorite dishes. The leader was an expert weaponsmith. He did not talk much, but he had the best weapons available to help us in our quest. Then there was a cleric, who was here documenting our journey. He also had some unusual items in his arsenal. And finally, the Iron Golem, hired to protect the crew. We sailed north, passing the huge coral reef, and arrived at a small dock in the desert. I was a little confused as to why we were searching for them on land. The drowned, however, were spotted by local coal factory workers at a lake in the desert. So we went there to investigate. While the crew searched around and set up camp, it was time for me to do my job. I found another ocean ruin in the bottom of the lake. This was a good sign. I pushed a hidden lever and a passage was revealed under me. This underground cave had to be the way. I swam back and told the crew what I had found. I got some resources and got some new weapons. It was time to go in the cave. I followed the path underwater and continued swimming. However, that fear started to creep up on me again. And I could feel myself falling down in that hole. The ocean was really dark in here. I was afraid of being attacked by something. Sometimes, no matter how dark it gets, we have to try to see the light. And I did see it, but it was not the kind of light that I thought it was going to be. It was just a glowing squid. And thanks to them, I was able to find myself out of the darkness. As I got out of the water, I saw daylight coming from somewhere above me. That was it. There was another way down here. As I approached the light, I saw a lot of coal on the floor. And as I looked up, I could see a lot of mining structures. The coal miners dug down from the surface and opened up this passage. From here, the crew would be able to join me without using the lake passage. Now that we were all together, I led the way. The frog senses helped me find the right directions down here. But we did not have to go too far. We continued going deeper into a small passage that led to a huge underground cave. There was something down there. Was something that shocked everyone. An ancient drowned city was right in front of us. This was a mega city. I could see roads, buildings, farms, and people all living together hidden under the desert. This was nothing like the ruins we come across in the ocean. I was amazed with what I was seeing. If there was a place Riptide could be, it would be in this city. The city was so big that it would not be possible to invade it and capture Riptide. So they had an atrocious plan to grief the entire place. The cleric brought stacks and stacks of TNT, and their plan was to blow the whole thing up and destroy, possibly, the last drowned city in the world, killing many creatures along with it. That was crazy. How could someone destroy an entire city full of people? I joined their crew in order to find the drowned leader and maybe put a stop on their attacks. But not like this. I tried to convince them not to do that, but they all had only two things in mind: revenge and reward. They wanted to get rid of the drowned and make some money at the same time. After a lot of debating, I was able to convince them not to blow up the entire place. But there was a catch. I had to go inside the city and bring Riptide myself. I had no other option. Going there alone seemed suicide. But I've done this sort of thing before. I'm a pro. And there he was. I found Riptide, unarmed. However, as I approached to attack, I froze. And as I took a better look at him, I realized what he was doing. Riptide was cooking. And it smelled delicious. How could I do this? They were not the creatures I thought they were. These were people living their lives like we were up there. Maybe he was not so different from me. There had to be a better way to resolve this. I asked him why he attacked our city, and he asked me the same thing back. I didn't understand what he meant by that. He told me that the coral reef ocean that I lived in used to be their home. They lived there before villagers migrated north and started attacking them. They were just fighting back to protect their home. He said that when the migration started, the land people killed many creatures that lived in the ocean and started to destroy the whole environment. Of course they did that. I have seen how much destruction people did up there. But I didn't say anything yet. He then asked me why I was helping the land people when a frog like me clearly belonged in the ocean. I always thought of myself as a villager who was also a frog. But maybe I was more like a frog who was also a villager? What was I anyway? It felt weird to be put in the spotlight like that just because of what I looked like. I just want a piece. Riptide told me something that only a few people knew. He told me about the age of exploration. The Age of Exploration was a period in time where a group of players created tools and weapons that allowed them to build, create, and reshape the entire world. However, those creations impacted the lives of countless other creatures, and the drowned were no exception. They were hunted and killed to almost extinction. This city was kept secret for thousands of days, possibly the last one in the world, but now that I knew its location, the drowned were in grave danger. After learning that new piece of information, I could see their side of the story, and I decided that it was best to tell Riptide the truth. Tell him that there were stacks and stacks of TNT about to be used to destroy this place. But I never had the chance to do that. This was not right. Genocide would not solve anything. I looked at the trident in my hand and realized that I could do something about it. The crew was attacking the place with TNTs. They did not have any intention of leaving this place alone. I realized that they just sent me here to die in the explosion. They even called the coal miner workers to help the attack. We stopped all the attackers and prevented the coordinates of the city from being leaked. And we returned the TNT that was left lying around to the people of the surface. It is funny that in the end, I sided with the drowned. I guess I understood them more than the people above, even though I still think that violence would not help solve anything. But that was a start. I could help them to find some middle ground and maybe live in peace. After all, we're all the same, right? There was something else that put a smile on my face. I think that I found an ingredient to use on my dish. All thanks to the drowned.